चलते हैं। प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी इस समय ब्रिटेन के दौरे पर हैं और आज वहां पर जो कुछ गतिविधियां रही और जो भी समझौते रहे, इस बारे में औपचारिक रूप से विदेश मंत्रालय के प्रवक्ता विकास स्वरूप मीडिया से
मुखातिब। लॉन्च ऑफ गवर्नमेंट सपोर्टेड रूपी डिनोमिनेटेड बॉन्ड्स फॉर द रेलवे सेक्टर एंड बॉन्ड्स लॉन्च बाय लीडिंग इंडियन प्राइवेट सेक्टर प्लेयर्स। दे अंडरलाइन दैट दिस कुड बी द स्टार्ट ऑफ अ लॉन्ग पार्टनरशिप इन दिस डायरेक्शन। Another important outcome was the setting up of a new India-UK fund under India's new National Infrastructure Investment Fund. In his discussions with Prime Minister Cameron and his address to the City of London, Prime Minister Modi underlined the government's strong commitment to continue economic reforms to attract foreign direct investment and elaborated upon the recent slew of significant liberalization initiatives which have made India the most open economy in the world. As you are aware, the CEOs forum is also meeting tomorrow and a whole host of business to business deals were finalized today amounting to over 9.2 billion pounds. As we speak, Prime Minister is in Chequers for an intimate dinner and continued discussions on regional and global strategic issues with Prime Minister Cameron in his countryside residence. So to sum up, the first day of the visit has been very successful and productive. We look forward to day 2, which as you know will feature the India-UK CEOs Forum. There'll be a lunch hosted by Her Majesty the Queen for Prime Minister in a very special gesture. And of course, there'll be the big diaspora event at Wembley, where Prime Minister Cameron will also be present. A total of 5 outcome documents and 11 MOUs were finalized today. And I'll just give you, some idea of what these documents are. The first is a vision document outlining the shared vision of both leaders for elevating the strategic partnership going forward. The second is a joint statement elaborating upon the diverse and multifaceted partnership and initiatives being taken to deepen it in a range of areas from economic development and finance to business, education, skills, health, science and technology and culture. There's an annex to the joint statement which gives details of 28 commercial business-to-business agreements signed during the visit. There's been the announcement of a defense and international security partnership to deepen India-UK defense collaboration through capability partnerships in strategic areas, including research, training, transfer of defense technologies and defense manufacturing in areas of mutual interest through Make in India. It also contains a strong counter-terrorism component. In fact, I think it's important that I read out to you the portions from that statement covering do you have that? The defense. I'll just read out the portion on counterterrorism. India and the UK stand united against terrorism in all its forms and manifestations and support the early finalization of a comprehensive convention on international terrorism. They will continue to work together to disrupt all financial and tactical support for terrorist networks including ISIL, Al-Qaeda, Lashkar-e-Toiba, Hizbul Mujahideen, the Haqqanis and the associated groups. The two countries reiterate their call for Pakistan to bring the perpetrators of the November 2008 terrorist attack in Mumbai to justice. The UK and India will continue to work together to prevent terrorist attacks and counter violent extremism, including through the exchange of best practices and technologies. Both countries will work together to drive forward international efforts to counter extremism and the ideology that underpins it. They will work through the UN and the Global Counterterrorism Forum to support action by governments to implement effective national strategies in partnership with communities, civil society, and industry. And then it also goes on to touch upon cyber, serious and organized crime, and maritime. All these documents are now available on the MEA website. You can download them. And as I said, once you have those documents, then you'll have a complete picture of what all has transpired today, the significant outcomes that have emerged from Prime Minister's first day in the UK, and of course, what we can expect tomorrow and day after. With that, I think I'll stop here. Nandini, you want to add something? Okay, we can open it up to the Q&A now. Yeah.
Hi, I'm Pinky. I just wondered if you could elaborate a little bit about the discussion we had with the Punjabi group, the Gurdwara, both for their request to
Well, as you know, they have certain issues, pertaining to their visits to India and things like that. And Prime Minister said very categorically, he says, look, India is your country. And you have every right to, seek what you want from India. And we'll be happy to have a comprehensive dialogue, in a spirit of free and frank exchange. And whatever we can do to assist you, we will do that. So my sense is that there will be probably a visit, whose phone is this? So these discussions, my assumption is that these discussions will continue.
In that case,
There may be a visit, as I said, yeah.
In that case, is there any talk about what happened in Punjab recently regarding the security of holy scriptures and all?
No, I don't think this was really in that context. The idea was that, there is a Punjabi community here and it has certain issues, and the idea was how can the two sides sit together and try to resolve those issues in a spirit of reconciliation, dialogue. Yes, this was raised very strongly. Prime Minister said that, Indian students in the UK, the number has fallen by 50% in the last 3 years. And he urged that, Indian students are among the best and the brightest in the world. And it would be a win-win partnership for both sides. Indians needing, quality education, and the UK benefiting from the expertise that Indian students bring to the UK.
If I may add, the Prime Minister actually said that we are right now in a situation where countries are actually wooing Indian students, because India is the biggest education market today. There's a burgeoning middle class, there's an aspirational upper class that wants to educate its kids abroad. And he said it's an opportunity to actually tap into what has become a big economic market.
And did you receive a response on that?
There was a lot of understanding and appreciation, but this is an issue that is a matter for continued discussion. I don't think we close the chapter
on
this.
What's the Home Secretary in the meeting? What's the British Home Secretary in the meeting?
No.
No.
To my understanding, no.
And she's the one driving the policy.
But anyway, the Prime Minister was there, so as far as we are concerned, the top man was there. Yeah.
Kaushik from Bloomberg TV India, could you detail the scope and the terms of the stability agreement in terms of phases for supply, phases for building plants, the expertise British companies coming into India, or is this your interest in detail on that?
I think all the agreements, the text also would be out soon, so you can see the details for yourself. But broadly, what I understand is it's a full chain agreement, that is the whole chain of the nuclear circle. And it includes research, it includes exchange of best practices, especially in areas like decommissioning, where the UK has superior technologies. And I think the context is far more important in a sense, because the UK is now commissioning a new nuclear plant. It is once again going in the direction of clean nuclear energy. So this opens up a whole world of opportunities for collaboration for both countries.
Siddharth.
Siddharth from Bloomberg TV. My question to you, sir, was to explain the components of the inbound investment that you just put out as a number, around $9.5 billion, slightly unusual from previous visits. For the first time, perhaps, a specific number being mentioned in business terms. Is there a breakup that you could offer us? And are these firm commitments, or are these ongoing sort of projects which have been collated as inbound British investments into India?
You'd be delighted to know that the full list is on the website. It's an annex to the joint statement.
Correct.
So it has all the details that the companies are willing to share.
But just to highlight a few, there's this agreement between the India-UK Institute of Health, between the India-UK Healthcare Private Limited and King's College Hospital. This is in the area of healthcare.
This valued
NHS. At NHS.
NHS partnering an Indian entity in setting up a medical college or a hospital with a training component in Chandigarh. And the plan is that they will open 10 or 11 more. So it's a chain of hospitals that they want to create.
I wonder if you could just talk about Vodafone, because one of those numbers was there and was something else.
The intelligent energy.
Vodafone
in terms of the tax controversies and what India has been trying to do to settle them.
In fact, I think Vodafone is voting with their pocket here. And
correct.
I think it's over 2 billion investment.
If no, 1.3 billion.
1.3.
Of which a significant amount. And the statement that we have is upgrading of current network and coverage. So, with all due respect, this is operational investment. This is not a new project that's coming up. So, again, in terms of scope of whether this is being expanded, have they indicated whether this is new business being set up or just the money you spend and UK companies, existing companies spend in business that they already do?
Now, on this, I'm afraid I'll have to direct you to speak to Vodafone. I don't.
Yeah, because these are, as you know, these are not G2G. These are B2B deals, and you know, we only have the data that has been given to us by those companies.
The simple point is that a company which sort of led a negative narrative about Indian economy and the closeness is today in the list of business contracts that were announced in front of the two prime ministers. To us, it's a significant narrative in itself.
One quick follow-up on the nuclear deal. Was there any talk of the kind of the liability terms that made conversation with the United States after a solid agreement slow down and projects pick up pace that slowed down in the United States? Were there terms that were discussed this time with the United Kingdom that said, look, this will not happen with the UK? Did they go into that analogy at all? Because we had headline numbers with the United States, but it went kind of nowhere because of those problems with
liability. You know, we've just signed the agreement today. You'll have to wait and see whether we have problems or not. It's a cooperation agreement, and it's a signal in itself. It's several signals, in fact, and it's a big positive story.
Manish.
ये था सीधा प्रसारण, जहां पर प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी के 3 दिन की यात्रा के दौरान आज पहले दिन की यात्रा के उपलब्धियों के बारे में विदेश मंत्रालय के प्रवक्ता विकास स्वरूप बता रहे थे, मीडिया से मुखातिब थे। उन्होंने कहा कि भारत और ग्रेट ब्रिटेन के बीच जो आज का मुख्य दिन रहा, वो उस दिन आज के दिन में 5 डॉक्यूमेंट्स रहे और 11 एमओयू यानी कि 11 सहमति पत्रों पर हस्ताक्षर हुए और 5 डॉक्यूमेंट जो हैं वो रिलीज़ किए गए दोनों देशों के बीच, जिसमें से एक विज़न डॉक्यूमेंट रहा जिसमें दोनों प्रधानमंत्रियों के दृष्टिकोण को समग्र रूप में स्थापित करने की बात कही गई। एक ज्वाइंट स्टेटमेंट रहा जो साझा बयान दोनों प्रधानमंत्रियों के द्वारा दिया गया और साथ ही साथ दोनों देशों के बीच साफ तौर से आतंकवाद के बारे में स्पष्ट दृष्टिकोण रखते हुए ये कहा गया कि दोनों देश आतंकवाद के मुद्दे पर विश्व में फैल रहे आतंकवाद के किसी भी स्वरूप की निंदा करते हैं और किसी भी रूप में फैलाए जा रहे आतंकवाद के खिलाफ लड़ने के लिए प्रतिबद्ध हैं, एकजुट हैं। और साथ ही साथ ये भी स्पष्ट रूप से संकेत दिया गया कि पाकिस्तान नवंबर 2008 के जो घटनाएं हैं उनसे संबंध आतंकवादियों को कानून के दायरे में लाए, ये भी स्पष्ट रूप से इस बात में कही गई है। और साथ ही साथ दोनों देशों के बीच रक्षा संबंधों को और ज़्यादा प्रगाढ़ बनाने, रक्षा क्षेत्र में सहयोग करने, शोध करने, साझा अभ्यास करने और अन्य क्रियाकलापों के बारे में भी सहमति बनी। 9.2 बिलियन यानी कि तकरीबन 9 अरब पाउंड के सौदों पर हस्ताक्षर हुए और चंडीगढ़ में एक मेडिकल विश्वविद्यालय, एक मेडिकल कॉलेज की स्थापना और अन्य ऐसे 11 अन्य संस्थानों की स्थापना की भी बात कही गई है। साफ तौर से यह स्पष्ट है कि मुद्दे ये भी उठे कि जो छात्रों को समस्याएं हो रही हैं उस संदर्भ में भारत के रुख को रखा गया, भारत की चिंताओं को रखा गया और उस बारे में भी सकारात्मक संकेत हैं। तो ये आज का जो पहले दिन का कार्यक्रम रहा और जो पहले दिन की उपलब्धियां और जो पहले दिन के परिणाम रहे उसको बता रहे थे विदेश मंत्रालय के प्रवक्ता विकास स्वरूप। उन्होंने बताया कि कल सीओ फोरम की जो मीटिंग होनी है वो कल होनी है। महारानी प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी के सम्मान में एक लंच का आयोजन कर रही हैं और साथ ही साथ कल के दिन अन्य अहम कार्यक्रम होंगे जिस बारे में विकास स्वरूप बता रहे थे। और अभी कुछ ही देर बाद जो प्रधानमंत्री डेविड कैमरून का ग्रामीण आवास है बकिंघम शायर का चेकर्स, वहाँ पर प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी के सम्मान में रात्रिभोज का आयोजन किया गया है और कल महारानी दिन में लंच का आयोजन करेंगी और साथ ही साथ सीओ फोरम और अन्य महत्वपूर्ण सम्मेलन तथा द्विपक्षीय बैठकें होंगी।